This is a Rubik's Cube. And this is an $85 speed cube. And this? And this is speed cubing. And in this video, I'll give you 5 reasons why it's almost inevitable that speed cubing will take over the world. And how these 5 reasons can lead to a huge problem. This video is sponsored by Empires and Puzzles. Later in the video, I will do some epic challenges, so make sure to keep watching. Ayy! Reason 1 for speed cubing world domination. It is fascinating. The Rubik's Cube was invented in 1974, and since then it has gained immense popularity all over the globe.
There's never been a puzzle quite like Rubik's Cube.
So much even that the Rubik's Cube became the most sold toy in the world. Almost 500 million Rubik's Cubes have been sold till this day. And there's something mesmerizing about twisting this colorful mess. The idea looks so simple until you try to solve it yourself. You will realize that this is way more difficult than you anticipated. If you don't have a clear manual explaining how to solve the cube, you just weren't going to figure it out by yourself. Dude, what are you even doing? The cube is solved. It took Erno Rubik's almost a month to be able to solve it himself. So unless you're smarter than the genius mathematician, I don't believe you. And please don't start saying stuff like, oh, I was able to solve 5 sides, but the last one was too difficult. 5 sides. Think about it. Its existence and difficultness is known around the world. Is difficultness even a word? So you can imagine that when you see this 12-year-old solve one in under 10 seconds, people are impressed, even fascinated so. Dude, are you okay? It was the reason I started cubing myself. I saw this video online of a kid impressing people with a Rubik's Cube and I thought, I want to do the same. And I can confirm it worked. Because 500,000 subscribers and 10 free Big Macs from winning bets later, the Rubik's Cube is still a conversation starter wherever I go. But the Rubik's Cube has always fascinated people. What's so different about it right now? Well, speed cubing is getting online. The reason the hype went down is that almost no one could solve one. Everyone bought one to realize they are idiots, and they didn't touch it again. The manuals were ambiguous, and the cubes were shit. But something got invented in 2005 that changed all of it. And no, I'm not talking about the Burger King finger fries. No, it was YouTube. Suddenly, normal you and me people could share moments, make jokes, teach people.
In this video, I will show you how you can solve the famous Rubik's Cube.
A Rubik's Cube is a 3D object, so explaining how to solve one on 2D paper is just really tough. But with the rise of online content, Rubik's Cube tutorials were undoubtedly going to be a success. My channel sponsor, The Cubicle, has a Rubik's Cube tutorial with over 30 million views. And my friend J-Perm, 40 million. And I? Well, let's just say I'm getting there. Cubing channels with over 1 million subscribers are emerging. Please help me get there. And it makes sense for this reason. First of all, it fascinates people, which results in views, which results in people becoming cubers, which grows the community, which in their turn will fascinate people again, which results in views, more cubers, bigger community, more people will get fascinated. It's a cycle that fuels itself, just like the Chernobyl disaster. And you know what else is a disaster? TikTok. Which brings us to point number 3. Speed cubing is educational. There is a problem with the internet. People are getting addicted to the internet without even realizing it. That is why this is one of my favorite books. It got me aware of how addicted online content can really be. Which is kind of ironic because what you're watching right now is online content. But something about watching this video or any cubing related video is that it feels less like a waste of time than watching TikToks, doesn't it? Please tell me I'm not wasting your time, thank you. And the reason is that the Rubik's Cube trains our brain. It is educational. I honestly think there's going to be a tipping point where internet addiction becomes so insidious and omnipresent that people are forced to limit their time online, or the time of their children. But what is the alternative? These kids need to be entertained. Well, give your child a Rubik's Cube. Even if they do get addicted, which will most definitely happen, it is still better than watching cat videos for hours straight. By the way, this is my cat Jeff. The Rubik's Cube is entertainment, but at least it's also educational. Talking about something that is both entertainment and educational, today's sponsor is Empires and Puzzles. Now, at first glance, this looks like a normal Match 3 type game, but it actually combines the Match 3 genre with exciting role-playing and this insane stories through magical worlds. Now, to tell you more about the game, I'm gonna do an epic battle. On the left side, I have to solve a 2x2, a 3x3, and a 4x4 puzzle. And on the right side, I have to do an Empires and Puzzles boss fight. These are my heroes for today, and by the way, you can collect over 400 heroes. That's insane. The goal is to solve all the cubes before I finish the level. And off we go, straight to the 2x2, which I finish in just 2 seconds. The dragon has barely gotten any damage at this point, but now a monster comes on the table to distract me. Now you guys should know that the different colors in the Empires and Puzzles game each represent a different element. Ooh, I finished the 3x3, just the 4x4 is left. Since the dragon is of the nature element, fire attacks will do the most damage. Good thing I have a huge fire attack coming. Also, the heroes at the bottom represent different elements, and each of them have a unique attack. I think you can see how the combination of Mesh 3 puzzles with game battles is insane fun. And since the game is already around for more than 5 years, there is so much content to explore. For example, you can upgrade your team and go toe-to-toe with other players in head-to-head battles. How cool is that? And with that being said, I'm almost done with the 4x4. And bam, I completed the challenge, even with a monster on the table. But not much later, I defeated the dragon. Oh yeah. And of course, I got some epic loot. You can download the game yourself by clicking the link in the description or the pinned comment. And while the game is free, speedcubing isn't quite free yet. But however, speedcubing is cheap. Do you remember the blocky, harsh turning, hair pulling because it's so frustrating Rubik's Cubes from back in the day? Well, they ain't the same no more. Some of the cubes right now have insane technologies. Maglev replaces springs to decrease friction. Adjustment systems let you customize the feel of your cube. Hundreds of magnets automatically align the layers. It gets crazy! And so does the price. Wait, that's not the point I was trying to make, was it? Well, as cool and innovating all the technologies are, you don't need all of that. One of the best performing cubes of the moment is the Moyu RS3M. It has magnets, it has a simple adjustment system, and it has crazy performance. The price? Just $8. Bam! That's cheap. It is so good even that I used it for the challenge earlier in this video. The exact version you see is YoCube Eco. It's fully customized and set up the way that I prefer, and people love it. Cubes being cheap is important for two main reasons. The first reason is that it is easier for parents to let their child get into the sport. If you're a parent, hint hint, Christmas soon, use discount code CUBEHEAD on thecubicle.com for a huge discount. And number two, the major part of the world doesn't have a lot of money. Let's take India for example. The average Indian income is about $400 per month. Spending $85 of that on a gift is hard to justify. But $8? That's doable. It's a very cheap hobby. And when talking about India, they are getting more and more online, which gives them more access to the internet, which opens the door to the tutorials. You see where I'm going? By the way, shout out to my Indian fans, I know you're all beautiful and smart. Which brings us to the last point. Speedcubing is getting smart. Check this Rubik's Cube. Notice anything special? It's GAN, so probably expensive, but what about now? This is a smart cube. And what it does is track all the moves you do on the cube and send it to your phone. And this opens the door to so many insane features that I think will revolutionize cubing forever. I'm talking about analyzing souls, cubing together, learning how to cube, sharing your solutions, on and on and on. The possibilities are endless. And although the technology is far from perfect, I have done hundreds of souls on the GAN i3 and it hasn't recorded any wrong move. Ever. Think about that, about 70 turns per soul, sometimes even over 10 turns per second. For hundreds of souls and not a single mistake? Wow. And talking about GAN, they are pushing technologies like never before. This case charges the cube. This cube timer connects to your phone. This robot? It scrambles or souls the cube for you. Can you imagine how useful this would be for cubing competitions? So yes, these features are cool, and it might make the cubing community more enticing, but that's not the point I'm trying to make, because the real truth is darker. Look what comes included with the new GAN 13. That's right, a sword. This is how it all ties together. Speedcubing fascinates people, and because it is getting online, people are going to want to learn how to solve one, which is possible because the cubes are so cheap, so people will get mad addicted to it. And because cubes are getting smart and expensive, everyone will spend all their money on cubes. The result? GAN will become rich so that they can build an army that will take over the world. Or am I overthinking this? Thanks again to Empires and Puzzles for sponsoring this video. You can find the link in the description or the pinned comment. Thank you!